Since all of us are similarly affected by the COVID-19 pandemic these days, chances are that you have something like this on your phone. This is the official German app for digital contact tracing, the CoronaWarn app. It uses Bluetooth to collect anonymous identifiers about the people you come into close contact with, and if a user tests positive for coronavirus, they can enter this information to the app and warn their recent contacts so they can self-isolate and get tested themselves. This app was the result of long public discussions about the advantages and disadvantages of apps designed to help fight the COVID-19 pandemic. One major point in this discussion were privacy risks, and especially if the data should be stored in a decentralized fashion. This inspired us to investigate how different data collection practices influence people's willingness to use COVID-19 apps. On a higher level, we were interested in people's general opinion of apps designed to help fight the pandemic, and the reasons for or against their use. Looking at COVID-19 apps from all around the world, we found that they were used for purposes other than contact tracing, so we were interested in comparing those as well. Since privacy perception, the state of the pandemic, and the availability of COVID-19 apps vary across cultures, we chose to conduct a representative online study in Germany, the United States, and China. Our approach was to present participants with different hypothetical apps, so-called vignettes, and let them rate how likely they were to use the presented app. Basically, a vignette is a text template with multiple placeholders, each of which could be filled with one out of multiple values. We call each of these colored blanks a data processing factor, and each possible item to fill in the blank a factor level. The factors were derived from a theory of privacy's contextual integrity. To make the factor levels as realistic as possible, we examined 43 COVID-19 apps recommended by governments and health authorities across the globe. Many countries have issued mobile apps for digital contact tracing, such as the German app I showed you in the beginning. But there are also COVID-19 apps for other purposes, to make sure quarantined people stay home, or to assess your symptoms and decide if you should get tested for coronavirus. In China, they have health certificate systems that require you to prove you're in good health if you want to visit a certain place. And finally, there are apps that simply provide you with information about COVID-19. Real-world corona apps collect lots of different types of data. For our study, we considered location data, encounters with other users of the app, health or activity data, the COVID-19 infection status, and unspecified data. Filled in with an example combination of factor levels, a vignette might look like this. From all possible and realistic combinations of factor levels, we computed for each participant a unique set of 10 vignettes. These make up the heart of our questionnaire. For each of the 10 app scenarios, participants were asked if they were willing to use the presented app, plus three other questions. Before this, we asked them about their smartphone use and their experience with the coronavirus. After, we asked if they used any COVID-19 app themselves and about positive and negative aspects of those apps. Finally, we evaluated their trust in institutions such as health authorities or governments and their general privacy concern. On a high level, across all presented apps, we find that participants' willingness to use is highest in China, lowest in the US, and somewhere in the middle in Germany. We performed a regression analysis to find out which factors and survey responses had significant positive or negative influence on the willingness to use COVID-19 apps. One major theme we found is that people appear to favor what they are already familiar with. In Germany and the US, the purpose of contact tracing had a positive influence on the willingness to use an app, probably because this was the focus of public discussions there. In China, it is common to send personal data that uniquely identifies a person to government servers, so this practice was viewed favorably by participants. In Germany and the US, we observed the opposite. Across all countries, previous use of corona apps had a positive influence on the willingness to use the presented apps. On the negative side, technical malfunctions made people in all countries less likely to use an app, and they also did not appreciate apps that sent data to private companies. In our paper, you can find a much more detailed analysis of the influence of factor levels and survey responses. Plus, we answer the question what people think of corona apps in general and why they may prefer not to use them.